So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build my own forge. So that way I can start to make things out of this steel. I'm going to start by breaking down this wheel, wire wheel here, so that I can get the cardboard center out. And if you don't have, you know, one of these lying around, I'm pretty sure this is 3/8 diameter, you can just go to a hardware store and get yourself a chunk of PVC pipe. They might even have scrap laying around that you can have. Who knows? Everybody's situation is going to be different. I like to use things around the shop that I already have. Why throw it away if I can make something useful out of it? So, take this off. I guess you're going to see a decent amount of time-lapse footage here, just because this is going to take a while. And you don't have to buy a brand new unused paint can. As long as it's metal, you can probably use any paint can. Some paint cans, though, are not metal. Some of them are plastic. I would not recommend making a metal forge out of plastic. So stick with stuff that doesn't melt. And this is going to get pulled out once it's all done. So. There you have it. It's dry. Looks like concrete. Definitely not going to mix it all up at once. And this whole entire bucket cost $27. So not too bad. Here I have an ice cream bucket. This is what I'm going to use. Mix up my forge cement. Before I mix up the concrete here, I'm going to quick poke a hole in my paint can. Now, I'm going to have about an inch of concrete just in the bottom of this. So I'm gonna have to put my hole, you know, up here. Because my goal is that the bottom here would be close to the cement on the inside. So let's go ahead and punch a hole. This hole, because I don't have a drill bit that's big enough. I'm just gonna grab my pliers here. Let me get a little closer so you can see what I'm doing. I don't have a drill big enough for this hole, so I'm gonna just grab on the inside and just kind of peel it like so. It's pretty soft sheet metal. You can pretty much work it without a lot of effort. And this doesn't have to be beautiful. This is a building a forge on a super, super small budget. I'm trying to make this so that anybody can do it. And I mean, you can see that's, it's not too bad. Perfect. See? Fits right in there. A little bit of ingenuity is all it takes. Now, I want my pipe here to create a vortex. So that is going to be a little harder. Because what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut a notch out of the bottom here. Ouch. Look at that. Perfect. So, stick this in there. So you can see what I'm doing here. I want this to be concentric to this, but I also want my pipe to come in on the side so it creates a vortex. And so, what I'm going to do is I line that up so it's centered, and then I twist everything to the side. And that's how I'm gonna hold it while I'm filling it with concrete. Let's mix up this concrete. I don't know how much it's gonna use, so I'm gonna start with this amount. And I want this just soft enough so it will settle. See, when I drop it like that, it all gets really flat. That's what I'm going for, right there. Go ahead and dump some in the bottom. Look at that. Perfectly level at the bottom of that. So that's how I want that. I'm gonna slide that. there you can see it's all full, pretty concentric. I shake it a little bit, that'll get the air out. Okay, so that's what it looks like from the side. I've got my pipe propped up. You can see straight on, it's off at kind of an angle. I had to shove this guy all the way down because it just kept coming in from the bottom. For the most part, it's pretty concentric. Okay, here we are, day two. You can see my breath. We are in single digits outside. I did have the heater running out here a little bit, but I have to turn it off to film. So, sacrificing for you guys. it's way too loud. So, it's set up. Now my challenge is gonna be getting this pipe out and getting this cardboard center out. So, we gotta get this pipe out. Good old 2-pound hammer will work great. This pipe is in there. So, gotta smack it a little bit. Now, when you tap side to side, just tap lightly. Because you want to loosen it. You don't want to destroy all your concrete on the inside. And of course, I can't just pull it out. So, big old pipe wrench always does the trick. And honestly, you could use, you don't need to use a steel pipe. I've found that, you know, if it were a pipe that I could crush and pull out, it'd be a lot easier. Like PVC, I could just break it out. This thing here is really in there, and it's completely full of concrete, so now I can't use it unless I can bust all the concrete out of the pipe, which is going to be a tall order. Okay, so I'm going to try to go ahead and see if I can get this cardboard out. Hey, before you start this, always make sure you have one of these right next to you, okay? You're going to be burning, messing with fire, things that are really hot in your garage. You don't want to lose all your precious tools. Be safe. Have this. And some safety glasses is a good idea, too. I hammered the pipe in. You can see, maybe, maybe not. You probably already saw from the top that I've cleared the passageway. Now I just have to get this pipe out. Get this pipe out. go. Now I'm going to go ahead and clean this up right here in the front by just tapping it. So I filled it with charcoal. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to light the charcoal. And I'm going to use the charcoal just like they did thousands of years ago. I will build a bigger burner for this furnace, but for now, I'm going to fill it with charcoal, get the charcoal lit, and then use an air source to make it hotter. Charcoal should burn hot enough, and the thing is, I can put a lot more of it in, and I can get a lot more heat out a lot faster without the map gas in that small burner is just not enough to fill that entire volume. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to build a smaller furnace that can run off this bottle. That's my goal here. And then I also want to build a bigger burner for a bigger furnace. Someday I want a really big furnace, but I'm just starting out small. I want to learn this and make sure I know all the ins and outs before I go really big so I don't waste a lot of money and fail. You know, I take small steps. That's just my philosophy.